वेलकम बैक गाइस. नाउ लेट्स सी द सेकंड क्वेश्चन ऑफ वीकली कॉन्टेस्ट 269. द क्वेश्चन इज दैट वी आर गिवन एन एरे ऑफ इंटीजर्स ऑफ साइज एन एंड एन इंटीजर के इज ऑल्सो गिवन टू अस. एंड वॉट वी हैव टू रिटर्न इज वी हैव टू रिटर्न एन एरे ऑफ एवरेजेस एंड इट्स लेंथ शुड बी एन एंड वेयर एवरेज ऑफ आई इज द के रेडियस एवरेज. एंड वॉट इज द के रेडियस एवरेज? लाइक इफ वी आर गिवन एनी एरे द के रेडियस एवरेज वुड बी like that at any index I with radius k is the average of all the elements in nums between the indices I minus k and I plus k inclusive. So this would be the average of all these 2k plus 1 elements. And if there are not 2k plus 1 elements, then we have to put that as minus 1. We have to take that answer as minus 1. And if 2k plus 1 elements are possible, like around a particular index, like k forward elements and k backward elements, if it is possible, then we have to return the averages of all these elements. Okay, so this is the k radius average. And for each and every index, we have to see plus k and minus k elements. If they exist, then we need to take the average of those. And if they do not exist, then we need to return minus 1 for that index. Similarly, for all the index we have to do, and we have to return the array of answers of all for all such indices. Okay, so now let's see the approach. Like its approach is also pretty much simple only. Like what we will first do is, like this is our array. So what we will do is we will calculate prefix sum. Okay, so what prefix sum means is, like if at like prefix sum is also an array, and if you tell that prefix of i denotes the sum of all the elements in the original array till the ith index. The sum of all the elements in original array. Okay, so this is our original array and this is our prefix array. Okay, so we will calculate all the prefix sum in this array. And now what we will do, we will simply run a for loop, and at each and every index first we will check that whether there are k elements forward and k elements backward, whether this kind of situation is possible or not. If it's not possible, then we'll simply push back minus 1 as our answer for that particular index. Otherwise, what we will do is, like as we have calculated the prefix sum, so prefix of I plus k minus prefix of I minus k minus 1. This will give us the sum of all the elements in this range. Okay, I will explain it like again through the diagram. I hope it might be clear to many of you. Okay, so here is our index I and here are the k elements, and here is our prefix array. Okay, so these are k elements forward, k elements backward. Okay, and like we have calculated the prefix array, and now what we need is sum of all the elements in this range. And why do we need this? Because we have to calculate the average, and after taking the sum, what we will do, divide it by 2k plus 1, because there are 2k plus 1 elements and we have to return the averages. Okay, so how we will take the sum? Sum, if we know, then we have to simply divide by 2k plus 1. How to calculate the sum? So now let's see that. As I explained earlier, that we have made a prefix array. So what we can do is, we can simply calculate this whole sum equal to prefix of I plus k minus prefix of I minus k minus 1. Why we are doing this? Like we are checking the prefix from here, like the sum of all the elements till here. That's what the prefix array denotes at a particular index. So prefix of I plus K, what it would denote? Sum of all the elements from the base index to this element. Okay, it will, prefix of I plus K will represent that. And what prefix of I minus K minus 1 will denote? This is I minus K minus 1 index. Sorry, this is I minus K index and this is I minus K minus 1 index. So what this will denote in the prefix array? The sum of all the elements till I minus K minus 1. So what if we subtract all the sum till I plus K? We subtract the sum of I minus K minus 1 elements from the sum of I plus K elements. What it would give? It would give the remaining sum. What it would be? It would be the sum from I minus K elements, I minus Kth index to I plus Kth index elements. This whole sum would be that. Okay. So we got that sum as this. Hence, our sum is calculated in big O of 1 only, because we pre-calculated the prefix array. So this would be it. And now we are done with our answer at a particular index I. If it is possible to calculate the answer, then we'll calculate by doing this. Okay, now let's see my submission like that. Now let's see the code. So yeah, I made a prefix array. And also one thing you have to remember is you have to keep it long end, because the sum can exceed, because the integer overflow can be there. Okay, so keep it long end. So I made the prefix array by doing this, and I have made a prefix array, as I told, like suffix array no need, but I thought that it might be needed, so I made it to ignore the suffix part, just concentrate on the prefix part. So what I have done is prefix of I plus 1 equal to prefix of I plus A of I. This is how I calculated the prefix array. And note that prefix array, I have made it 1 indexed, because you can see prefix of 1 equal to, like at I equal to 0, you can see prefix of 1 equal to A of 0, okay. And prefix of 1, prefix of 2 equal to, like, which means I equal to 1, prefix of 2 equal to prefix of 1 plus A of 1, which means what was prefix of 1? A of 0, A of 0 plus A of 1. Hence, this is how I am calculating through the for loop. So similarly, now I have calculated the answer, prefix of I plus K minus I minus K minus 1, okay, divided by 2K plus 1. And if it is not possible to find K elements forward and K elements backward, then I am pushing back minus 1 in my answer vector. Okay, so this is how I have done it. So thank you very much, guys.